Google Cloud Architects training course. And this is what we are going to discuss about in today's session. But before jumping directly to the course, let me take a few big names like Gmail, most used mailing service, Google, world's biggest and the best search engine, and finally YouTube, the biggest video sharing website, isn't it? And all these big giant companies are powered by one and only Google Cloud Platform, that is GCP. And this goes without saying that how well we have been using these services all these years without any hiccups. And hence, it gives the platform a thumbs up while choosing the domain as your career. Let us tell you that GCP is not the only cloud computing platform available in the market. There are many, but then today we are going to discuss about the three big players in the market, and these are Amazon Web Services, Microsoft Azure, and of course, Google Cloud Platform. Now the share they have is quite visible on the screen. But while considering AWS's big share base, one also has to take cognizance of its time of inception. AWS made available for customers long back in the year 2004, and Azure came into existence in the year 2010. But if I talk about GCP, then it's the newest one in the market and was launched in the year 2011. And we therefore can conclude that being the newest one in the market, it has done quite well and offers over 60 services. Now there are by and large two factors that influence what course you are going to take up. And these are of course employment and salary. And if I talk about employment scope into this domain, then infrastructure as a service is the fastest growing segment of the market, which has grown by 35.9% in 2018 to reach $40.8 billion, says Gartner. And as far as salary is concerned, an average salary of a cloud architect is $139,000 per year, says Indeed. And hence we have sorted from both the end, from salary point of view and employment point of view as well. And hence, IntelliPart brings you an exclusive Google Cloud Architect course, which will help you gain 360 degree of proficiency. And again, this course is the combination of instructor-led, self-paced, and real-time projects. And is also curated by the top architect, rather cloud architect of the industry, who exactly know the requirement of the industry. And now let's talk about the course in detail. So the topics that are going to be covered are first, introduction to Google Cloud, Google Cloud Services, Computing Services, Storage Services, Cloud APIs, Networking Services, IAM and Security Services, and Migrating to the Google Cloud. Let's have a look at these in detail now. So under Introduction to Google Cloud, you are going to be taught A, Fundamentals of GCP, Overview of Services, and Overview of Infrastructure. And then if I talk about Google Cloud Services, then you'll be taught Infrastructure as a Service, Platform as a Service, and Serverless Computing. And under Google Compute Services, then there are many components available, so few of them are Compute Engine. Now this allows you to create your own virtual machine by allocating hardware-specific resources, for example, RAM, CPU, and storage. It is also very hands-on and low-level. And then the second one is App Engine. It allows you to focus only on your code, and Google would handle all the underlying platform requirements. Then Kubernetes Engine. Now this allows you to use Kubernetes and containers to manage your application, allowing it to scale whenever needed. Cloud Functions. Now this is the final step in the compute pyramid, and it allows you to write a simple function. And if I talk about Google Storage Services, then some of the most important components are as follows. Cloud Storage. Now cloud storage is highly scalable and handles unstructured data that comes in a variety of formats such as pictures, text documents, and log files. Persistent Disk. Persistent Disk is Google's scalable block storage solution. Its features include, let's say, automatic encryption of data at rest and multi-reader mounting, whereby many virtual machines can share data on a single persistent disk with no degradation in performance. And then Cloud File Store. Now this one essentially offers a fully managed network attached storage service in the cloud. And then we have got Google Cloud APIs, wherein you will be taught CloudVision API. Now, this can be used to understand the content of an image into categories, and then detect individual objects and faces within images, and find and read printed words contained within images. Cloud Speech API. It can be used to convert audio to text. The API recognizes over 80 languages and variants. Natural Language API. Now, this can be used to parse the structure and meaning of text, and it can extract information including the people, places, events, and sentiments within a provided text. And finally, Translate API. Now, this can be used to translate an arbitrary language string into any supported language. And language identification is available for cases where the source language is unknown. And now let's talk about Google Networking Services. And under this, again, some of the important components are Virtual Private Cloud. It is nothing but a set of Google managed networking capabilities, including granular IP address range selection, routes, firewalls, virtual private network, and cloud router for provisioning your GCP resources, connecting them to each other, and isolating them from one another in a virtual private cloud. And then we've got cloud load balancing, a service that load balances and auto-scales GCP compute resources in single or multiple regions behind a single Anycast IP. Then we have got Cloud CDN. Now this uses Google's globally distributed edge points of presence to cache load balance content close to users. Then Cloud Interconnect. Now this allows GCP customers to connect to Google via higher availability and or lower latency connections than their existing internet connections. And Cloud DNS. It is a managed authoritative domain name system service running on the same infrastructure as Google. Cloud DNS translates requests from domain names into IP addresses and offers a UI, command line interface, and API for publishing and managing millions of DNS zones and resource records. And after this comes IAM and security services, wherein we have got Cloud IAM. Now it lets the administrators authorize who can take action on specific resources, along with built-in auditing. Resource Manager, a service for programmatically managing the resource containers, such as organizations and projects, used to group and organize GCP resources. And Cloud Security Scanner. Now this is a web security scanner for common vulnerabilities in App Engine applications, including cross-site scripting, flash injections, mixed content, and outdated insecure libraries. And after this, finally, we have got the topic migrating to the Google Cloud. And here you'll be taught data transfer, transfer appliance, cloud storage transfer services, and BigQuery data transfer services. I hope the video was informative for you. And if you want to go in detail about this course, you can simply reach out to us through any channels displayed on the screen. And our course advisor should get in touch with you regarding your learning query. I hope the video was informative for you. Please like the video, and if you have any doubt, comment below. We shall respond to it at the earliest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more detailed information, visit our website now. Have a great day and career ahead.